please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
See, the first thing is I'll be concerned about what the UIDAI officials want to say, have commented on my report. The UIDAI officials have confessed that there is a misuse of the grievances redressal facility and the data has been breached. And they have claimed that they're going to lodge an FIR against those who have done this breach. Now, it is yet to be identified that who are those anonymous people who have sold the data to over 3 lakhs of VLEs, as claimed by my source, who is one of them, that it has been provided to them at 500 rupees. So this is what UIDAI has to say.
Yeah.
And they have endorsed the report written by the Tribune and by me. So I put it on to the government. They have the politicians, they are seniors, they have the right to say whatever they are.
Has anyone from the government contacted you, Rachna, or contacted the Tribune?
No one so far. No government authority has contacted us. In fact, I'm sure that the government is taking it very seriously. There is some kind of lack of CI officials, and I'm sure the government is definitely going to take a stern action, and it is going to plug this loophole as soon as possible.
All right, Narendra Taneja, spokesperson for the Bharatiya Janata Party. You know, the BJP has called this report fake news. The UIDAI has denied the media report that's been published in the report, and it's called it a case of misreporting. But you acknowledge in the statement that's been put out by the UIDAI, as Rachna Khera just said, you acknowledge the fact that the reported case, and I'm quoting here, the reported case appears to be an instance of misuse of the grievance redressal search facility. So you acknowledge the fact that misuse had taken place. Further, you say the Aadhaar number is not a secret number. It is to be shared with authorized agencies whenever an Aadhaar holder wishes to avail of certain services or benefits from the government. The fact of the matter is it's unauthorized people.
Well, three points quickly. Number one, yes, this is indeed fake news and misreporting. And number two, even the person who has the grievance cell of UIDAI, even he or she doesn't have access to biometrics.
Let's qualify that. You're saying that there is no breach of biometric information, but there is a breach. There is a data breach. If Aadhaar numbers and associated information with the email IDs, phone numbers are accessible, there is a data breach. It may not necessarily be biometric information, but you cannot deny the fact that there has been a data breach.
No. There are two sides of Aadhaar information, biometrics, and the other information is name, gender, date of birth.
Sure.
That information, if you go on Google and search for Election Commission of India, all that information is available to you. You can check the age, date of birth, address, and
Is that really a responsible response, sir? Then why are you filing FIRs, sir? Why is the UIDAI filing FIRs if, as you are saying, there's absolutely no sort of importance or significance attached to this data? Then why file FIRs?
What do I do if you don't let me speak?
No, please go ahead.
You have to allow me some time to build my point.
Sure.
To build my argument. If you have decided that the government is hiding something, or there is a breach, then it's a different story altogether.
Please go ahead, Mr. Taneja.
I have nothing to say.
Please go ahead, sir.
So now the point is, when it comes to what is Aadhaar data, you tell me, please. What is kind of, there are two parts, mainly two parts. One, the general information, which I said most cases is available on Election Commission website. If you go to Election Commission website, you can find out all these details. Available 24/7 on Google. Number two is biometrics. That is the most sensitive information, which in any case, in other cases, when we travel, we apply for visa, we travel overseas, we do give biometrics data at various airports, those who travel.
To an authorized agency, sir.
Let me come to this. So I'm just making two points. Number one, data which are easily available and on Google search from Election Commission and number of other websites, number one. Number two, biometrics. I repeat it. When it comes to biometric, absolutely no breach, and I say with all responsibility. When this report came out, I'm told out of Jalandhar, not out of Bangalore, the IT capital of Bombay, Delhi, out of Jalandhar. We don't know why, of all the places, Jalandhar, with all due respect to the reporter. But the question is that, you know, the question here is that there is no truth in it. It's misleading, it's fake, it's just based on WhatsApp kind of information. I mean, for the information, if you want to know anybody's address, date of birth, you don't need to spend even 300 rupees. Why are you spending 300 rupees available for free on Google?
Okay.
When it comes to biometric, impossible.
No breach whatsoever. All
so where is the news? I don't understand. What are we discussing here?
Okay, where is the news? We don't understand is the point of view there of the BJP spokesperson. Rachna, very quickly, I want you to respond to that before I bring Sanjay Jha in.
Two things, Mr. Taneja, I would like to ask you is that, as you said, that the data is available, we don't even have to spend 300 rupees. Can you share your mobile number here on this news channel? If your mobile number is available all across the public domain, can you share your husband, your wife's mobile number? Can you share your children's mobile number right now here with us? Please go ahead. Please go ahead and share your mobile number and your family's first mobile number with us.
No, listen. Your argument, first of all,
Please don't divert the question. We are on the channel. We are live. Please respond. Will you be able to share your personal mobile number and your wife's mobile number with us right now?
I heard your question. Who gave you the right? You are writing fake news. Don't talk to this man. Instead of appreciating the media. Who is this person?
Loophole.
I'm not here to. Who is this street type of talk?
One second, Mr. Taneja.
Learn first. Talk in a dignified way.
Talk in a civilized manner.
I'm not coming here to answer questions of somebody who's writing fake news.
Mr. Taneja, let's not make accusations. Be dignified.
First, learn manners.
Mr. Taneja, can we
ask questions gently in a civilized way and allow me to answer it? This is not a tutu manner.
No, it is not a tutu manner. There is no need to hurl accusations, sir. She's asking a question. Please respond to that. I'm giving you time to respond to the questions that have been made.
Yeah, now give me a chance to respond.
Just one second, Rachna. Mr. Taneja, just a second, Rachna. Mr. Taneja,
who is this person? Who is this reporter?
Mr. Taneja, please
let us not make this personal,
Mr. Taneja. A question has been asked. I am asking you the question, sir. Please go ahead. I am asking you to answer, Mr. Taneja.
Yeah. Number one, question she is asking me, can I talk about my mobile number is available? Put my name on Google search, my phone number is available.
Okay.
And in Aadhaar card, you don't write the number of entire family or neighbors and relatives. You don't need to do that.
What I'm saying is
the general information which is available on website of Election Commission, that's available to anyone and everyone. Why waste your 300 rupees? As far as biometrics is concerned, there is absolutely no breach. These are two simple points. Unless you really want to quarrel because you have done this fake news and now you want to kind of justify, this is a different story. You've had your say, sir. As I pointed out, let's not hurl accusations at each other, sir.
That is unfair. Let me bring Sanjay Jha into this conversation.
No, I'm not hurling on anybody. I don't recognize the fake news reporters.
All right. Thank you, sir. Sanjay Jha, let me get you to respond to the comments that you've heard.
Wow. Well, you know, Shireen, to be honest, it's rather repugnant that on a day when there has been a serious data breach, I think this is a very grave development. And hats off to the Tribune for exposing it. And I would request my BJP counterpart to kindly read the entire newspaper piece because it gives a graphic description of how the entire process flowed out with details that you cannot just kind of come on a TV channel and treat with your usual political hubris. I'm concerned, and I'll tell you why. Let Mr. Taneja, he's free to put the mobile number of his own, his family, and whoever whatever he wants on the internet. But the truth is that we have a right to privacy given to us by the Supreme Court of India, and I intend to protect mine and that of my family and anybody I know. Shirin, I think the issue here is very grave. I'll tell you why. Because at the moment, you'll remember in Jharkhand government, they leaked massive data out in the public domain of Aadhaar.
Yeah.
No action, no FIR was ever put because the laws are so actually lopsided that tomorrow if your details, Shirin, or my details are leaked out, we can't even file a police complaint. We have to go to the UIDAI. Mm. And the UIDAI has done practically nothing.
Yeah.
Now, I have every reason to believe, I'm not cynical like Mr. Taneja, that if the Tribune reporter, and she's on your channel, and she said that the UIDAI has confessed that there has been a data breach, who's the BJP and the government to pretend as if everything is hunky-dory? Mm. There's no harm in acknowledging you have a serious problem. And one of the reasons, Shirin, why this problem is escalating is because the government, without even waiting for a Supreme Court verdict, has made it mandatory for virtually all kinds of commercial personal transactions that you and I take, whether it's a life insurance you buy or a mutual fund I invest in. That's a separate matter. The reason why we are all vulnerable.
Yeah, that's a separate matter. But, I wonder if we do have Tadhakar Satpathy with us. We're trying to get him on the phone as well. But, let me take the point forward that Sanjay Jha just made. As on October 2016, Mr. Taneja, 556 enrollment agencies and 125 registrars had access to the Aadhaar database. Between September 2010 and October 2016, the UIDAI has received close to 1,400 complaints about data leaks. How many of these have been converted into police complaints against enrollment agencies, Mr. Taneja? Only three, sir. Only three. Yes, you say that the law protects you and that it is an offence under Chapter 7 of the UIDA Act, which lays down penalties for unauthorised access to the database. But out of 1,400 complaints that have been filed about data leaks, sir, merely three have been converted into police complaints.
You see, according to UIADI, I'm just quoting them, and it's an agency which was created at the time of the Congress Party. Sanjay Jha is calling me cynical. This has happened in Punjab. This report is coming from Jalandhar, which is ruled by Congress Party. I'm not suggesting anything.
No, but it's important to keep that in mind. It, sir.
You see, the
You're
point here I'm trying to make...
You're very clearly suggesting that you believe this is a political point, conspiracy.
I'm appalled.
No, I'm not suggesting
Shirin,
anything.
I'm appalled that he
what
believes
I'm suggesting
this is a political
is, well,
conspiracy. He needs to explain.
What I'm suggesting...
Listen, Mr. Taneja, either you have a substantive charge with evidence or you don't make a slide.
Mr. Taneja, please.
Can we please stick to the facts, sir? Congress can do anything, but let me make my point. Yes, I asked you a question that is based on fact. I would appreciate it if you could respond to that, sir.
No, I'm responding to it. As I said, the government has come out with a statement today. At the level of the government of India, it has been made very clear there is no breach. And when I say the general information, that does not mean that information has been leaked. Absolutely no question. That has not been leaked.
Mr. Taneja, I'm reading out to you, sir. Again, for the benefit, I will read out to you what the UIDAI statement says. The UIDAI statement acknowledges, it says, sir, the reported case appears to be an instance of misuse. The UIDAI itself is acknowledging that there has been misuse, Mr. Taneja.
Exactly.
Well, if my Aadhaar card, if I've lost my Aadhaar card, if you have lost your Aadhaar card, when I took my Aadhaar card, a private contractor came in a community hall near to my house. That time UPA2 was in power. They asked me for everything and I gave all the information in trust. If I lose my card, if you lose your wallet, and that information, that number is used by someone else, how can you blame the UIADI, the government, for that?
Okay.
If MS Dhoni leaves his form of Aadhaar card somewhere and somebody makes a copy of it,
okay.
I mean, can you blame the UIADI for that?
That's the point.
Okay. All I'm saying is that produce solid evidence that the government has, on the part of the government, there is any breach. We can have a discussion on that.
It is not. The fact that there has been a breach has been established, and it is a fact that's being acknowledged by the UIDAI itself in a statement that it's put out this afternoon, sir. You can choose not to see that as a breach, but the misuse, and I'm using that word because that is the word used by the UIDAI in its own statement, has been acknowledged by the UIDAI today, sir. Let me go across to Tadhakar Satpathy. Mr. Satpathy, Sarpati.
So I gave you the example.
Sure, sir. But
I gave you the example.
Let me go across
there
to
are,
Mr. Sarpati.
There are some cases
sir,
like that
had,
based on
sir,
similar
you,
examples.
Yes, Mr. Sarpati, you probably have heard the conversation that's been going on here in the studio. The government says that this is fake news, it's misreporting, there has been no data breach. And to be clear, let's qualify that. There has been no breach of the biometric information. Has there been a data leak? The Tribune report suggests so, and the UIDAI's own statement suggests so. Mr. Sarpati, where do we go from here now?
Actually, I'm sorry I joined you late. I was on the road and I couldn't hear all the conversation. I heard one gentleman saying something. See, I am not getting into any party thing here. This whole Aadhaar thing is not a baby of the BJP.
Sure.
It's a concept, it's an idea, an evil idea that was started by the Congress during the UPA government. And the BJP only took it forward because they understood what kind of a evil power it is.
Yeah.
And as far as breach is concerned, breaches are concerned, it's not this time, first time that the UIDAI has admitted a breach. Mm. It has happened multiple times.
Yeah.
So everybody is aware about it. And when all other countries, including the UK, which had collected biometric data, they're all going back and they have spent more money destroying the data than they initially spent to collect it.
Mm.
It shows that the world at large is understanding the evil that this kind of an information can, you know, can create for the average citizen.
Mm.
Now, it's another matter that in India, we are not so very conscious about privacy because our lifestyle is such that we are quite, you know, we think it is okay if somebody else, if our neighbor knows what is happening.
Mm.
But in reality, in a changing world, in a modern world, privacy is becoming a very important aspect,
yes,
which the Supreme Court has also recognized.
Yes, it has, sir. And hence the need for a robust data protection law. There is a committee that's looking into this matter. There is somebody who sought information about the workings of that committee and where things stand by way of an RTI.
No.
Yeah.
Ma'am, listen.
Yes.
Listen. It is not only the law that can protect. What happens is this is technology. In the present context, India does not possess the technology. And as we know, people from Bangalore who gave birth to this idea have quit this organization and run away. The idea is that technology does not exist in India which can protect all this data, that is this humongous amount of data that is being collected. Now, there is one very important industrialist businessman in India, one of the top two or three, who said data is the new oil.
Yes.
Now, let's not take this very lightly. Data is the new oil means if you are mining me, for that kind of oil, my data is oil for you, you are going to make money out of it. If you are going to make money out of it, God knows now, 2 years later, 5 years later, maybe this government changes within that time, but my data is gone forever.
Sure.
When you are making money out of it, what is the country going to do, get out of it? First thing. Second thing is, who all will have access to this data? When people are saying that we have gotten rid of 30,000 fake old age pensioners, in reality, what is happening? Their fingerprints are not matching, their iris scans are not matching, and you are depriving genuine old Indians from getting their pension, and you are claiming you are getting rid of fakes.
Mm.
So I don't know, is it the people who are claiming that they are fakes or the people at large? Who is a fake?
Okay. All right, we're pretty much out of time now, so let me give final comments to each of our panelists here. And Rachna, let me start by asking you, you know, what is it? I believe you also, Rachna, did try to access the biometric information, but there you did not find any success.
Shireen, at this point, I just want to tell you that the investigation it has just begun in the case, and we have managed to find certain facts which we need to be identified at the moment right now.
Okay.
I will not be able to comment on that particular issue.
Sure.
But definitely, I would like to comment on this thing that the Aadhaar card, the information may be available on public domain, but it is only available to the person whose Aadhaar card is there. He has to get an OTP on his mobile number.
Mm.
Whereas the operation which we did, we managed to secure the details of Aadhaar card without getting any OTP to that person.
Okay.
Right, number one. Number two is that, as I said, that the UIDAI has already said that it has lodged an FIR. It is going to lodge an FIR. So I'm sure that they have accepted the lapse, and I am hopeful that the government and the opposition and the officials will take it very seriously. And will definitely try to plug it. The loopholes as soon as possible.
Absolutely. And that would be the hope as well. Narendra Taneja, I'll give you the final say. The hope is that, you know, whatever needs to be done to ensure that the checks and balances are put in place to avoid in future the misuse of the kind that's taken place, whether you acknowledge it to be a breach or not.
It cannot be avoided.
Mr. Satpathy believes it cannot
be
avoided.
It just has to be scrapped there.
Well, no. It's unlikely that that's going to happen. Let me give the final say to you, Mr. Taneja.
Let's have faith on the Supreme Court.
I repeat that. There is no... Let me speak now, please. The question is addressed to me. You see, this claim that there is a breach of biometrics, this is absolute false. Is fake news. No truth in it.
No, nobody's claiming that. Nobody's claiming that, sir. No one is claiming that there was biometric leak.
The second...
But that has happened in the past.
All other informations are available in public domain. A number of public domains, those informations are available. Number three is a technology. It's an evolving technology. And evolved, it was introduced by a Congress party. We have taken it. We are still working on it. But technology is always a challenge.
Okay.
But we are trying our level best to bring in the best technology and to bring
in
the best
laws. He's being disingenuous. He is distorting the truth.
So people hope that
the record,
government
he
will
is
also
actually
evolve.
You can continue with your lecture.
We're out of time.
Well,
you are misleading the viewers of CNBC.
Congress is liar. Everybody
TV
knows
no,
it.
No,
that's
no,
why
please,
you were thrown
gentlemen,
out.
Gentlemen, let us.
You have no data security.
You only speak lies.
No name calling.
Bunch of lies.
No name calling.
Congress means bunch of lies. Nothing else.
There is no technology.
No respect for anybody. No respect for anybody.
Let us not bring the debate down to this,
Nehru family. Except Nehru family. No respect for Republic of India.
Mr. Taneja, please.
No respect for Government of India.
Mr. Taneja.
No respect for anybody except the family.
Mr. Taneja, can we please not? Please, I would appreciate it if we stick to the facts and we stick
that.
To the issues.
He is
let's,
doing
let's
that.
Not.
He is doing
we,
that. The
let's,
servant
let's,
of the
let's
first,
focus on the
servant
issues.
Of one family.
Let's focus on the issues that we have to deal with, which is a serious issue, and it is an issue that requires everyone to take a constructive approach. Let's approach this issue with the substance and meaning that it requires, and let's not make this conversation about issues that are not relevant to it. Sanjay Jha, Narendra Taneja, Tathagat Satpathy,
I hope Congress spokesperson
and Rachna Khaira, appreciate you joining us here on CNBC TV18. Thanks very much for your time.